Maybe yes, I don't know exactly what you wanted to send to me. I have some other ideas. I had no time at all to have contacts here in Djibouti. But my situation is quite different. So, no, I wanted to come back if it's possible. The question of why I would have to leave and have left the country for years and asked him or why he's still leaving the country. I think it's mainly political. I believe I lived here as a reporter for 4 years, between 1991 and 1995. When I arrived in Bulgaria, it was 2 years after the end of communism, and the constitution has just been adopted. People still had hope in a kind of state of war, rule of law, and democracy, and so on and so on. And also in the West, we had the same hope. We were all of us very pretentious. We thought it was possible to create a democratic society just like this, with text and money. But it's not true at all. And we see the results here now. So we also see the results in the camp of the Hungary, where the evolution of the country is getting worse and worse. So we know now that at least it's the only thing that can bring rule of law democracy in the country is time, years, generations. You have to, for me the main, what I've learned when I came back and what has impressed me more is that I had a completely different youth as the people of my generation. When the communism collapsed in Eastern Europe, I was 25. So which means that I have been educated my whole life, even I studied in political sciences, and when I studied, all that I have learned, that was these two worlds that were existing in Europe. This has completely disappeared. And the people here, they had lived in an opposite world that was completely closed, with no contact with us. We had no contact at all, neither. But it was not all decision. And the people here were in another room. Now, you have the same youth as my children. You lived almost in the same world. Of course, there are a lot of cultural differences. But nevertheless, you lived all, you were all educated in an open world. In a country where you have kind of democracy, kind of free press, free movement, free everything. Of course, the level of economic development or whatever is kind of different, the food is different, so on and so on. That's not the main, that's not the most important issue, I think. But the most important issue is that now, you know not in you, but the principles in which you were educated, which are democracy, freedom, and so on and so on, they were really existing, and they are realities. When I was young, I was living in countries that was democracy-free. In the eastern part of Europe, it was also called democracy of freedom. Right. It was said the country was popular.
People's.
It was not for the people, it was not for the particular. All the words were the same. The words were the same. We are using the same words. But for the eastern, for Bulgarians, no those words were empty, totally empty. So my generation, again, was educated with words, with concepts that were nothing. So I'm not really surprised that maybe the generation that is now 50 or 60 had kind of a difficulty to understand what democracy has to be and is, because all these words that were used were empty of any sense. I think that's the main difference. You were educated in a world where these words had a signification. So that's why I'm very hopeful for Bulgaria. Although you need to be patient, and you need time to go. Only after one or two generations, Bulgaria might have a better rule for than today. And if I compare Bulgaria in the current situation over here as it was 20 years ago, I also can assure you that it's clear that you have made huge efforts, and your state of law, your rule of law is really more efficient and real than it was 20 years ago.
Okay, thank you very much.
Well,
Finally, I just wanted to answer and to drag Constantino. Because we are together because of this spring of traveling to university, the fifth one, for the fifth year in Cyprus, made by our education and workplace centers. With the interdisciplinary, that's students from absolute different specialties, scientific specialties, from different universities, from different nationalities. We are here together in Cyprus. Why? Why you come here? Why you stood not in Sofia if you don't want to be here? Why our association formed here during this practice? That's only questions and questions. And I'd give you just some answers to Dragan Constantin. We are working here. We are making sustainable development. With this print university, with this traveling university, we are making a real practice of sustainable development. With development sustainable this region, this town. We are doing it. And that's why I'm here, because I can't do it this here, and I cannot do it in Sofia. Here is possible, with Vienna is very difficult. With all these different difficulties, here is possible.
Искам да покажа вас специално на българските високи на правилите в България и като друг и не да
само по-силно.
И госпожа Борин и Йорданка Сапирова от местната общност.
Кал ще превеждаш.
Това, което на мен много силно ме е мотивирало да продължим, беше 2010 година по време на третата ни лятна практика в Тулешния университет. Задачата на студентите, пак отново няколко работни групи, беше да работят и да дадат предложение за развитие на устойчив туризъм и общо на устойчиви практики на региона, да ги дадат като предложение по време на заседанието на Общински съвет на община Чипровци. Влязахме там, дадохме тези предложения. В Общинския съвет много се дебатира, всичко ни отричаха и нападаха. И остава впечатление, че в крайна сметка нищо няма да става. Това беше моята голяма изненада, когато миналата, следващата година, дойдох тук и видях работата, която студентите бяха свършили с ръцете си. Става дума за табелите, примерно, Чипровския водопад и Кушевския манастир. И точно там, където са техните препоръки, къде те трябва да бъдат поставени и заедно с тека, къде тя трябва да бъде поправена. Защото аз съм изпитвал на тези практики и знам всичко какво са писали, какво са снимали, какво са ни представили, какво са предоставили за физиката. Всичко беше изпълнено. Това е абсолютно невъзможно да се случи в столична община и във всяка една голяма община.
Хора, които имат силно развито чувство за приключение. от нас считам за човек, който са на много сферата на държавната местната администрация, че законово се пречи на бизнеса, не му се дава възможност да рискува. Няма гаранция, което обезпечава и малките начинания на създаване на работни места, на бизнес, на инициативи. Много би полезно било за нас, евентуално, ако организирате и помогнете с млади хора, които да ни обучи, все още останалите предприемчиви хора в нашия край, най-вече за развитие на бизнеса. Или за някакви инициативи, ако ще те дори са самите хора. Лично аз виждам добро бъдеще на общината за развитие на животновътството и съпътващи си към дейности от тази зависимост за производство на млечно и на мечта и така нататък. Имаме чиста и хубава природа, вие сте забелязали. Предполагам, че това е една от причините да ви хареса, че си издитвате честно. Надявам се, че ще станете приятели на чиповци и ще популяризирате добрите страни на чиповци, като силно се надявам проблемите, които имаме, поне да ги афиширате, да ги превършите, защото считам, че общината не е на това ниво, което трябва да бъде и като инфраструктура, и като отношение. И хората още в движение случат да променят отношението си към различните, към младите, към инициативите. Малко трудно приемам нещата. За съжаление, аз чух и разбрах, че вие и вие го видяли в очите си, че тук са повече възрастни хора. Хора живяли при други условия, при други ситуации. Трудно възприемат проблемите. Но аз се надявам, че най-вече на младите хора, че имат готовност, имат цели и желание да променим заедно това. Готов съм да си сътрудничам с млади хора във всяка една сфера. Силна нужда има от идеи и млади хора, дори ако щете и само чрез интернет контакт. Има нужда от идеи. Аз съм сигурен, че вие ще видите през бъдите сте минали доста интересни мисли идеи. Не само сферата на туризма, основно с което се насочи, а и към тези други страни на икономиката. Поздравявам ви още един път за това, че сте избрали чиновници. Надявам се, че ви е харесало и се надявам, че сте станали приятели за винаги на чиновници. Благодаря ви, че избрахте чиновници.
Надявам се да сме съборили няколко прегради, сигурно сме изградили някои нови. Непрекъснато го правим, както вчера каза Жиро Ел, това е своята прекрасна презентация.
I hope we brought down some of the barriers. I'm sure we also built some new ones. We're doing it all the time, as Жиро Ел said yesterday.
Но съм убедена, че това, което направихме, беше хубаво, полезно и sustainable, надявам се. Да използваме тази хубава българска дума.
And I'm also sure that what we did was good, useful, and устойчиво.
You can all put that in your CVs. You can put it in your CVs.
We were really impressed, and I personally was called for the Hebrew Stiftung. We are a foundation of social and democratic orientation. And our main goal is like fostering democracy, as well as in Germany, as well as all over the world. And part of fostering democracy, of course, is empowering civil society. So that's why we do things like, that's why we support things like, yeah, as I told before, I'm impressed, or I think that in Bulgaria, you are in a good way. And I hope you keep the spirit. And also, another thing about Project is that we don't do things for ourselves. We always work with partners, project partners. So our work can all be as good as the work of our project partners. So I would like to thank especially to all the organizers, the co-organizers, of course, to Petra and Carlos Vetter for the very good cooperation. And I would also like to thank to all the participants and the lecturers. As I learned, many of you do this work voluntarily, so thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Ambassador, to be here and also to lift up the spirit even more. And so I hope we can continue in this way together.
You have the floor.
Just one more. Thank you very much for your work. And thank you very much, Mr. Mayor, for to welcome all of us. And just an announcement, because this kind of event is not end. And we can go from Chiprovci to Sofia now, because on Monday we will continue the debate, as I said to one of you, about the degrowth and so on. With Markus Veta, with Peter, with Serge, who is here, and with others. And I hope that all of you can join us at 6 o'clock on Monday at the French Institute, and to discover for some of you the new room we have, and that is absolutely open for all the debate you can have between us, even each nationality we have, with German, with French, with Slovak, and with Bulgarian. So I hope see you in 2 days after the election. Yes.